Initializing the Verizon Quarterly Intelligence Briefing, the Cybersecurity Edition, featuring Chris Novak and Tony Sager.
Welcome to the first ever Quarterly Intelligence Briefing by Verizon Business, your source for essential updates, insights, and information surrounding my favorite topic, cybersecurity. I'm your host, Chris Novak, and today we're exploring the thrilling and ever-evolving realm of cybersecurity. In this episode, we're going to talk about cybersecurity basics, a new service from Verizon around risk quantification, things you can do right now to help safeguard your business, things you should be doing right now, and educating yourself and your team about the coming SEC regulations. And we'll have a special guest from the Center for Internet Security. Let's dive right into today's topic. The new regulations around reporting cyber incidents are cresting the horizon. These rules aren't someday maybe regulations, and we know here at Verizon that the best way to stay secure is to be prepared. Welcome and thank you for joining our quarterly intelligence briefing. And along with me, I have Tony as my guest from the Center for Internet Security to help us really dig into the details. So Tony, tell us, what industries or types of organizations do you see as being impacted by this new SEC regulation?
Yeah, I think the intention is good, and it's going to be the industry, all of the above.
All of them.
And I think that's the important part of this, right? It implies that you have a certain level of visibility of your enterprise assets that many companies don't have.
Yeah, no, and I would agree. And I would say, you know, at the end of the day, it's about kind of education and awareness around what it is you need to do. To your point earlier around the assets, you know, we see it time and time again, organizations need to know what assets they have. And I know historically the technologists would usually, you know, I need this tech, I need this firewall, I need this widget. And the executives might not totally be able to understand or appreciate, what does that do to help me from a risk standpoint? Why do I need that?
There's 1,000 good things to do
sure.
in this industry. You can't do thousands of things, right?
Right.
We need to help people focus in on what is critical. Well, that's determined by how are the bad guys attacking us today. But what we never had in the past was a rigorous way to kind of model all this. Go to our site, cisecurity.org, and look for a reference to Implementation Group 1, which is our techno name for what we call essential cyber hygiene. So we tried to trim down sort of the barest set of things that we think everyone should do, no matter what your industry, what your size, what your sophistication, and make it very accessible. A lot of that you can do with the tools that you have.
Right.
And again, I would take those kinds of steps first.
We've started moving in that mm-hmm. direction of actually offering a cyber risk quantification service, trying to help organizations individualize those numbers for themselves so they can say, this is what it means to my organization, even if it means something different to someone else, incidents still happen. Mm-hmm. And so the ability to kind of have that cyber SWAT team parachute in and help you recover quickly from that and be able to mitigate those damages, that is very critical.
Yeah, again, these are good business practices, right? Whether we're talking about cyberspace or physical assets. So it is important to have that conversation with whatever your company leadership is. And it's not about fear, it's about, you know, are we being responsible? I just want the audience to know you did not put me up to this. But I often tell people, if you don't know where to begin, because it is confusing, read the DBIR. It's very readable, it's in plain English, and it gives you a sense of the scope of the problem and breaks it down beautifully, right? And you don't have to understand every technical aspect of it, but it's a really important starting point.
From a Verizon perspective, we've got a rapid response retainer that's helping organizations every day. That's what we specialize in, getting in, helping organizations quickly. The other thing is cyber risk quantification. If you need to be able to report to the SEC, or for that matter, anybody, understanding and being able to quantify your risk, whether it's for internal or external, is critical. And that service is specifically designed to do that. Tony, some thoughts you want to share?
We all know this from sports, right? Defense wins games. But offense in cyber, even fake offense like red team and so forth, wins budgets. Right? It's, you know, because we want this drama.
Sure.
We think we need some magical thing. But the foundation of defense is just good discipline, good management, good visibility. And if you don't start there, you can buy lots of technology with no success.
At the end of the day, when we look at the SEC regulation and things like cyber risk quantification, it helps organizations really, truly understand what their risk is. And that is foundationally important to actually securing their enterprise, securing their assets, securing their customers, securing everything. I know this is a lot of information to digest, but don't worry, we're going to link all the information in the captions so you'll be able to get everything and follow up with those resources. With that, I want to thank Tony. Appreciate you being out here with us. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, Chris. Appreciate it. I appreciate the audience's time and attention, and appreciate the longstanding partnership that we have with your teams.
You bet. It's a pleasure.